Did I just get up and have I yet combed my hair? No, I haven't. But that doesn't mean we don't get to talk about a class 9 triggering of a feminist who has seen a Christian with an anti-abortion sign. Now, I'm of the opinion that even if you don't agree with this Christian, then he has the right to say what he's doing, especially given how he's not causing any trouble. He's just standing there politely with his sign, saying, this is my opinion, this is what I'm doing, I have every right to do it, and you have no right to stop me. Enter triggered feminist.
Ma'am, please don't attack my sign.
Go home! Go home!
And
go
please,
home!
Please don't.
Just, I can't imagine what someone could put on a sign for me to just start attacking them and their sign, screaming, fuck you, go home, fuck you. I can't imagine getting that angry about anything they put on a sign. Like, even if they were like, freedom of speech, go to hell, like, there are Muslims in the United Kingdom who walk around with free speech, go to hell, democracy, go to hell. And I don't go, well, fuck you, I'm going to attack you. I go, okay, well, you've got your right to say it. And to be honest with you, I'm kind of glad you are, because I like to know that there are people who are actually anti-Britain, anti-democracy, and anti-free speech. It doesn't make me attack them out of rage, though. I'm guessing that this feminist regrets her abortion.
Don't destroy my son, ma'am. Please, ma'am. Ma'am, why are you so angry?
It's not going to ease your conscience if he goes home. You're still going to have the weight of the unborn child that you murdered on your conscience. It's not going to change, is it?
Why wouldn't I be? You're a piece of fucking shit, go home!
Is he a piece of shit? Is he really a piece of shit? Because I judge people being pieces of shit by their actions, not by the things that they necessarily say or believe. I judge people... Who the fuck is banging? But, yeah, I think just standing there with a sign that you disagree with doesn't make him a piece of shit. Actually, I have to say, though, you attacking him and screaming fuck you at him, that does make you a piece of shit. I mean, honestly, any neutral observer to this surely is going to look at the feminists and go, right, okay, I found the piece of shit.
Oh, pick up your shit, we don't need that bullshit here.
Yeah.
We already have...
We? You mean you? You don't need it. You clearly really don't need it.
We're not going on. I'm a fucking woman in this world. We're women of this world. You have no place to say goddamn shit about nothing.
What kind of reasoning is that? We are women, therefore you have to shut up. That's not how it works, I'm afraid, love. I mean, that's the same rationale if I would say, I'm a man, therefore you shouldn't vote. I'm trying not to laugh, but she's really funny.
You're being murdered down the street, ma'am.
Whatever!
I need to speak up for them. Ma'am.
Oh, wow, she really regrets her abortion, doesn't she? It's 9 in the morning. Someone's hammering next door. They weren't hammering 2 minutes ago. Fuck's sake. But, yeah, she really regrets her abortion, doesn't she? Like, I love the just, just the outraged noises. She can't even articulate why she's angry. She's the intellectual here, so, you know.
Please.
Man, please, I just want to exercise my constitutional rights. Look at them. That's such a great pause. She's like a fucking... She has regressed to her primitive gorilla primate ancestry. She's now just hulking out on the street. Ah! Oh, come on, dude. I'm not re-recording this, so you know. I bet it's a feminist. No, of course not a feminist doing real work next door. What the fuck am I talking about?
Go home! Go the fuck home!
No? I'm not even on this Christian side on this argument, but like, technically I'm on her side in this argument, but it's just like, you've got no right to just scream at him and tell him to go home and then try and force him physically to go home. He's done nothing wrong. You're the one doing something wrong. If anyone gets physically removed from this altercation, it should be you. Because you started violence?
You have no right to do this! None whatsoever!
I think he does. I think he's got every right to do this. In fact, I have a thing it is constitutionally enshrined, which I'm telling you, Americans, do not let them ever tamper with your First Amendment. If anyone ever says, right, we're going to have to talk about this First Amendment, you just do not even entertain the conversation. You just flatly shut them down. No, not up for debate.
Freedom of speech be damned! Go the fuck home!
Freedom of speech be damned. There we go. Thank you very much. Feminism 2018, ladies and gentlemen. So, she's just like, fuck your rights. Fuck your rights. It's like, what? Well, okay, that puts you in the same position as Saddam Hussein, Adolf Hitler, and Joseph Stalin. Just saying, that's their opinion too. Fuck your rights. That's their opinion. You have now taken on the opinion of all of the worst dictators throughout all of history. He is actually exercising his rights, as he has every right to do. And he is now the representative of Western liberal democracy. You're the one who's opposed to it. But sorry, carry on, Miss Feminist.
Yeah.
I know she's a miss as well.
Support the animals.
You need Jesus Christ, ma'am.
I need Jesus.
You have a lot of anger, ma'am.
I need fucking Jesus.
You have a lot of anger.
To be honest with you, I don't often say it, but she really does look like she might need Jesus.
Of course I'm angry. I have every right to be angry.
Yeah, I'd be furious with myself too if I had an abortion and I felt really bad about it. I'd be really furious about this. And I think you have and you do, don't you? I don't know that she's had an abortion, but let's be honest. No one's going to fucking react like this to an anti-abortion sign if they haven't had an abortion and don't deeply regret it.
The only reason you're not angry is because you're a privileged white man in America.
Oh. So she's going to be racist and sexist then? But I guess, he is out there protesting about something that makes him angry. He's just doing it in a respectful way. I mean, why do you think he's there? And like I said, I don't even agree with him. But I think he has every right to express his feelings, and you're the one who's saying he doesn't. Because he's so fucking privileged.
Why are you angry?
Why am I angry?
These are children who are being murdered and they need a voice.
Yeah, that's what's making her angry, dude. She's, in what you've just described there, she's the murderer.
The person that could potentially carry that child. I care about my life. That's that child. There's a lump of cells that is yet to be born.
And that's what she told herself when she was getting her abortion. She doesn't care about the child. She cares about her life. Modern women. No, modern feminists. I'm so sorry. I would never tar women with the brush of feminism. I'm so sorry, ladies. Jesus, that was irresponsible of me to say. No, that's modern feminists who are like that. They care about themselves and nothing else.
A baby,
that's a little human being who came into being at conception. They're living in the first stages of life.
Yeah, human beings aren't really human beings if they're small and underdeveloped enough, my friend. But what I love about this is that it is like you could have chosen not to have unprotected sex. There are lots of options, love, for you to not get pregnant. I mean, you could have taken a morning after pill if you were, if you were being irresponsible, you had unprotected sex, you're like, right, just take the morning after pill, then, like, something that is something you could legitimately call a bundle of cells, like a barely, an egg that's just attached to your ovary or your cell wall, uterus lining or whatever, however it works. You could say, yeah, that is just a couple of cells. You know, you have the morning after pill, it leaves your body, no one's going to say anything. You know, no one's going to complain. This guy probably wouldn't even be able to complain about that. But what you're doing is inappropriate, and you know it, and you've got to double down on it, because you hate yourself, because you bought into all of the stuff that it's okay, and in fact, it's a moral good to have an abortion. I'm surprised she doesn't have her I had an abortion and I'm proud t-shirt on.
And they need to be loved and cared for and supported in the first stage of life inside the body of their mother.
Dude, we already...
She got a spray can. Why are you... And I love the way she doesn't even take off her bag to get it. She's like a holstered. Holstered fucking spray can.
Establish that's not what it says in the Bible.
Yeah, I
God.
Ma'am, don't destroy property.
No haga vandalismo. I don't know why he's
going
to get it. Oh, look at that face. That's it. You're going to get it now. You've hurt my feelings. Fuck your rights. Fuck your freedom. Fuck you. I'm going to put an end to this, said the tyrant. it's like a feminist version of Dirty Harry. She's like, that's it, scumbag. You've broken no laws. You've done nothing wrong. But you've really hurt my feels.
Ma'am, don't.
I'm bigger than you. I'm smarter than you. I'm better than you. Go home.
Wow. That's amazing, because I think I might be bigger than her, stronger than her, and better than her. At least where it counts. Because she's literally just saying, might makes right. That's it. I can defeat you, and therefore I am justified. That is the opposite of justice. That's the opposite of the purpose of law. That's the opposite of the purpose of human rights. And also, I don't think those things are true. You don't seem to have been able to take the sign off him. If you were bigger and better than him, you probably would have been able to. I think that you have a massively overinflated sense of your own importance and ability, and I think that real life probably will end up catching up with you. She's acting like she's got some authority over him here, which she doesn't.
Love these children, man.
She doesn't love anything but herself. In fact, she doesn't even love herself. Look, she's clearly hating herself because of the things that she's done. And she's taking this out on you, friend.
I need to speak up for them. They're being murdered. They need help.
No.
Yeah, it is. The destruction of an innocent human being.
It's a humano.
Go home!
Standing on a bench doesn't make you more right.
Go home!
If you're ever faced with a feminist or any kind of protester really, who's just shouting as their method of trying to stop you, just wait. You can't shout for very long like this. You know, give her 5 minutes and her throat will be absolutely hoarse. And then you can continue speaking at normal volume and she won't be able to speak back.
Go home!
Don't be so angry, ma'am.
Go home!
So you can already hear her struggling, can't you?
Okay, do you want to go to a different spot?
She's already had to give up. Look at that. What was that, less than a minute?
You
think that will help?
Not right now.
Excuse me, beta cuck, shut up. No one needs to hear from you. You literally don't believe you have the right to speak in this conversation. So this isn't the thing. Never debate one of these betas. Never do it. Just tell them no. You're not important enough to talk to. I did this at Boston. Some little beta guy came up to me and he's like, oh, so I'm going to want to ask something. I just said no. I'm not talking to you. And he was like, oh, okay. I'll talk to the people that you put in charge, because this is a hierarchy. This is you are arguing just from strength here as well. The beta cucks have got absolutely none of it. Don't waste your time with them. They are just a distraction. Talk to the female feminists and the black feminists. Talk to the ones who have been empowered by this movement. Don't talk to the orbiters.
Okay. Can I just pray for you?
Yeah.
Father, I thank you for this man, and I just pray that you give him courage. Father, I thank you that you just silence all the enemy in Jesus' name, and I just thank you that...
That's really not his opinion, though, is it? I mean, maybe, let's be honest, maybe he does want to silence all of the enemies in Jesus' name, but that seems to have been what the feminist wants, just not in Jesus' name, she just wants the enemy silenced. I've not seen him try to silence anyone. He hasn't told her to stop shouting or anything, but, you know, go ahead and you project your anti-freedom values all over this poor chap who just wants to stand up for what he believes is right, whether you agree with that or not.
You're moving people. Thank you. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you.
Stand strong.
And he just said, okay. That's the end of it. She doesn't let fly with the spray can. I love how she's wielding it like it's a weapon. But yeah, this has been an absolutely glorious start to my day. It's only 10 past 9 at this point, and I'm already having a great day. I've got a debate, well, not a debate, a panel with Milo and a few other people at Cal Poly. So I imagine we're going to get some protesters there, which should be fun. I'm taking a camera and hopefully I'll be able to record it all. And I'll upload it and let you know how it goes. It's going to be about fake news. So you'd think that the feminists would have a lot to say on that, because there's a lot of fake news going around on both the left and the right, and it's something to be talked about. But what are you going to do?